हेलो फ्रेंड, दिस इज आकाश मिश्र हियर एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल दैट इज मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग मेक इजी। एंड इन दैट आई एम मूविंग विथ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग। दिस इज फोर्थ लेक्चर एंड द कास्टिंग इज गोइंग ऑन नाउ। ओके, मेटल कास्टिंग पार्ट। एंड इन दैट नाउ टुडे आई विल डिस्कस द गेटिंग सिस्टम। ओके, सो व्हाट एग्जैक्टली द गेटिंग सिस्टम? आई हैव ड्रॉन वेरी सिंपलेस्ट फॉर्म ऑफ गेटिंग सिस्टम, दैट इज वन देर इज पोरिंग बेसिन, दिस इज स्प्रू, ओके दिस इज स्प्लैश कोर, स्प्लैश कोर, देन इट इज रनर, इट इज स्किम बॉब, इनगेट, कैविटी एंड राइजर। ओके, दीज आर नंबर ऑफ कंपोनेंट्स। व्हाट द फंक्शन ऑफ पोरिंग बेसिन? इट प्रोवाइड्स, मीन्स वी आर गोइंग टू पोर मोल्टन मेटल फ्रॉम वन लैडल। ओके, लाइकवाइज, सो पोरिंग बेसिन दिस प्रोवाइड्स ईजिएस्ट पोरिंग ऑफ दैट मेटल। ओके, दैट मेटल विल अल्टीमेटली have up to that point. Okay, and because of that what happens, the at the end from the end of this pouring basin, inner only material will be there, not any air is going to trap. That's why the shape of sprue is likewise. Okay, means air can escape from here. That's why likewise the shape is here, pouring basin and sprue. After that the splash core, okay, splash core is used here. After that the runner. What the purpose of runner? To take water, to take the material, molten metal from sprue and provide to the cavity. Okay, this is the runner. And in between that runner we have placed one skim bob. It is given for any fluctuation. If there is any fluctuation takes place because of this pouring metal, or if there is any air, so that air will be taken here or here. Likewise, for that the skim bob is used. And after that there is ingate at the entrance of cavity. The ingate's function is to provide molten metal from runner to the cavity. Okay, then this is the cavity which we have to fill by molten metal. And this is the riser. Okay, what's the purpose of riser? To compensate number of allowances. Okay, like shrinkage and etc. If the metal shrinks here while solidifying, then the riser will have extra material that will be gone again into the cavity, and that will solidify and that will occupy whole the cavity. Okay, this is one function. Another function is that to know that cavity is filled properly or not. Likewise, number of functions are there. Okay, this is very simplest form of gating system. I will go in some detail. So draw this figure. I will go now to the next point. And next point is nothing but gating ratio. As we have seen, first sprue, then runner, and then ingate. So gating ratio is nothing but gating ratio is nothing but sprue area is to runner area is to ingate area. As we have seen, first there was sprue, after that runner, and after that the ingate. So sprue area is to runner area is to ingate area. It is the gating ratio. Okay, this is the formula for gating ratio. In gate exam the question may come that what is the gating ratio, likewise, or they will give the gating ratio is 2:4:2, likewise. So what exactly the area of sprue, what exactly area of runner, that we can get from that. Okay, then types of gate. Types of gate means that ingate we have drawn, that gate may be, okay, if this is the cavity we have to fill, that gate may be at the top of cavity, that gate may be at the side of cavity, that gate may be at the bottom of cavity. That's why depending on that, the position of that gate, that ingate, the types of gate are there. Like parting line gate means mold cavity, maybe this is the mold cavity and this is cope and this is drag. So this is parting line, and if gate is provided at the parting line here, if the gate is provided, then this gate is called as parting line gate. Okay, then top gate, same figure is there, only we are providing gate here, so that will be top gate. Okay, then next is bottom gate. Again, same what I have discussed with you, that gate will be here, and likewise the sprue runner, likewise, or that may be here. This is also one type of bottom gating system. Okay, then side gate means at any side or not directly on parting line, that may be at the bottom, at here or here, at any side, at this side or at this side, and at any height of that cavity, that gate is called as side gate. And parting line gate is also one kind of side gate, we can say. Okay, these are the four types of gate. Then velocity. Okay, we are pouring the molten metal, so that velocity of that molten metal, that is an important point for us. Velocity denoted by V, which is equal to 2GHT in under root. Okay, 2 is constant, G and HT, that is HT is nothing but height of molten metal that contains the sprue height plus the height of molten metal in pouring basin. What the HT is, the sprue height plus height of molten metal in pouring basin. Like if this is the pouring basin and this is the sprue. Okay, so from this to this, this is sprue height. Let it is HP, but the molten metal is up to this height. So this small h, we have to take care of that. So HT will be small h plus HP. Okay, this is the formula of height we have taken for velocity calculation. Okay, so note down this formula, and if you want, then draw this figure and this formula also. Otherwise, you can have in wordings the meaning of HT, that is sprue height plus height of molten metal in pouring basin. Okay, then pouring time. It is not solidification time. Okay, solidification time is too much common. That's why we always think that in casting only one time, that is solidification time. But there is one another time also, that is pouring time. And what exactly it is, that is nothing but volume of casting upon flow rate. Volume of casting upon flow rate. Okay, what is pouring time? Means how much time will be required to fill that casting. If this is the casting, then how much time will require to fill this all casting with the molten metal. So what are the parameters for that? Okay, so flow rate means how much meter cube per second we are flowing. Molten metal in meter cube per second, how much we are going to flow, and the volume. So meter cube upon meter cube per second, the second will be at upside and we will get the pouring time. Okay, this is the concept of pouring time. How much time will require to fill that mold box? That is nothing but the pouring time. Then next is flow rate. Yes, means what we have discussed in pouring time, that is flow rate. Flow rate, we know, area into velocity. Okay, so minimum area into maximum velocity we will take, because we know the relation between area and velocity. If area is minimum, then velocity is maximum. As flow rate is constant, means Q is always constant from pouring basin to the ingate directly. So the as the q is constant and q is nothing but area into velocity, so as area varies, the velocity will vary inversely. So that's why we have taken minimum area into maximum velocity here. Okay, and what are the next parameters? That is nothing but the Vmax. Okay. So what exactly the maximum velocity? We have taken into consideration one formula, that is velocity equal to under root 2ght, but again this is the theoretical velocity, and that is ideal velocity, but practically there are number of things, that's why the velocity will decrease. So we are going to take care of that with the help of eta. Okay, this is into 2ght into eta, and this is the formula for that pressure is atmospheric pressure. Okay, if pressure changes, then ultimately if pressure is higher than atmospheric pressure, then the flow rate will increase, because we are giving more force to that molten metal to go, okay, as pressure increases. That's why, and this is the velocity for atmospheric pressure condition, that is under root 2ght into eta. And what exactly eta? That eta is nothing but efficiency of that flowing molten metal, because that is going to have contact with all the things like pouring basin, then sprue, then runner, then ingate, and etc. So because of that, number of parameters are there, like we have taken into consideration the friction losses, minor losses, so that will going to play a part in that. So that's why we are going to take one term here, that is eta, that is efficiency of flow rate. And this is the formula for atmospheric pressure. Okay, so friends, we will move towards today's lecture's bonus points. Bonus points. So what are the bonus points for non-pressurized gating system? Okay, means for P is equal to P atmosphere, it is the non-pressurized gating system, and if P is greater than P atmosphere, then this is pressurized gating system. Okay, so we will take into consideration that is nothing but the gating ratio. What exactly the gating ratio for P equal to P atmosphere? And that gating ratio is 1:4:4 or 1:2:2:2. Okay, this is the gating ratio for non-pressurized gating system. Means what exactly it is? Sprue area, then runner area as to ingate area. Okay, this is the gating ratio. And what are the values generally for non-pressurized gating system? 1:4:4 or 1:2:2. And for pressurized gating system, that is nothing but P is greater than P atmospheric, then that gating ratio will be generally have value 1:2:1. Okay, this is all about what I have designed for today's lecture. And if you enjoyed the session, then please like and share this session. And for such a latest update, and what the content I am giving, that is only for you. Okay, so please subscribe my channel so that you will get latest updates from me. And in fifth lecture, that is nothing but this was the fourth lecture, I will come up with fifth lecture. In that I will going to discuss number of concepts like the flow rate for top gating system, bottom gating system, then the solidification time, heat to be removed, then riser design, and etc. So please do subscribe my channel, and thank you friends.